So take a moment to just think about who you are, and let me know when you're done.
I've been thinking a lot about who I am. Who I am. Okay.
Okay. What was a childhood passion of yours?
I grew up on a farm and riding horses was awesome. I loved it. Going out in the fields and just riding and being free was a huge part of my childhood.
A childhood passion of mine was making people laugh. I really enjoyed encouraging people and making them laugh, even from a small child.
As a child, I used to draw sketches of buildings and cities all the time. When I was very little, about four, I would sit there and draw skyscrapers all over the pages that I had of this notebook, and I would just draw skyscrapers and buildings. My mom thought I was for sure going to go into architecture.
I didn't really get much time to go out and play when I was a kid.
Yeah.
When I got to go play hockey, I was like, yeah, I'm going to go play hockey today. So I was like, yeah, I'm chilling.
It was like your break from life.
Right? Otherwise, I just found myself work today. I've always worked my whole life.
Childhood passion would be me and my friends, we would always just pretend that we were like, let's say, certain animals or certain characters from a certain thing, just different people, and we'd always have fun pretending that we're that person or thing. And then we would just hang out and we would just pretend we're different scenarios, and we'd always do that.
I like to dance. I used to like to dance when I was little a lot. And for like performances with my sisters and my cousins for like Christmas or dramas or stuff like that.
Would you say that you see a difference in how you share what your passions are in life now than as you did as a child?
As a child, I was a free spirit then, and I'm a free spirit now. But I think as we grow older, we become more mature and we're able to temper that craziness that we had as a child, so free and running around wild.
Well, when I was that age, I lived on a farm, and now living in the city, I can't act on that passion as often. However, when I do go back to where I grew up, I do like the horses, but I think probably being able to be free and to have such wide green space and open space to be able to enjoy the outdoors and to be able to have a farm life when I was a child, I'm a little bit freer as an adult too, where I just love enjoying life and love the freedom of open space and being able to just be free.
Yeah, I would say as a child you don't have any reservations, right? You don't really seem to care that much, especially when you're a little child. I'm talking like eight and under. You don't really care what people think about something you're passionate about, so you just kind of run around yelling it or being who you are, I suppose. As a school, you age, you just kind of become more reserved, I suppose, and you don't share that with the exact same enthusiasm as you would with someone when you were a little child.
Yeah.
There are moments when things I'm passionate about, I get quite emotional, I guess you could say, whether it be raised voice or facial expression, you can see it. But I don't think it would ever come to the exact same extent as when I was a child, or at least pretty rarely.
You know, at the end of the day, I'm just playing hockey with my neighbor, so
yeah.
It wouldn't really be...
It seemed pretty simple, I guess.
Yeah, it was rare for me to do it, and so whenever I got the chance, I was pretty lit up with that.
Yeah.
Otherwise, it was just kind of one of my rare hobbies. I didn't really have many hobbies, but I
guess so, yeah. Because when you're little, you don't really care what other people might think. So when you grow older, society says, oh yeah, don't do this, don't do that. So it's not as freeing, I guess you could say.
Definitely, as a child, you'd share your passions more just whatever you think personally, and you would just say it. And you wouldn't really think about anyone else, really, or how they feel or how they think about it.
Yeah.
You just say it, right?
Yeah.
Whereas now you think more how to say it, you think what they're going to think about it, and you just think it a lot more than normal.
Mm-hmm. And how do you represent yourself truthfully to others in life?
I think the best way to like present yourself is how you feel you're most comfortable with, and being more truthful to yourself than others sometimes, because what matters is that if you're truthful for yourself, then you're truthful for others as well.
Definitely, definitely.
I'm just me. I'm just genuine. Who you see is what you get. And I think as you mature and get older in life, you learn to temper some of those things. And I think I've grown in grace over the years. It's part of me to just be really truthful and just, hey, I just say what I feel. And you have to learn to be gracious over the years so that you don't want to hurt anyone.
Well, I never pretend. I'm always real with whatever I say. There's nothing really for me to hide. And the thing is, if I hide, it doesn't, it's not hidden for long.
Yeah.
Yeah, I just, you know, just being honest with whatever I think and who I am is just out there. Right?
Yeah, so, absolutely. Yeah.
Depending on the setting, I mean, I can be a different person at work than I am with my children, depending on kind of what role I'm in. As far as being professional at work or being at the park with my children, of course, I'm going to be freer and enjoy life.
Well, it's a little bit like difficult because I feel I speak Spanish, and like I have to do that switch when like if I'm talking to like Spanish-speaking people,
right,
or English. Like I think I feel like my personality changes a little bit
by being honest, expressing what I'm feeling in a, I guess, respectful way of their feelings, but being honest at least. I also try and be diplomatic, which can sometimes obviously obscure your true self or what you're truly thinking. But I think generally speaking, I'm a fairly honest person. So that would be, I guess, the way I would present my true self to people, through honest interaction.
Yeah. Would you say that there's different versions of yourself for different settings in your life?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
It depends on who I'm with.
Yeah, you know, definitely.
Whether they are okay with the foul language or certain type of music, you know, even what they eat, if they're vegetarian or they're carnivores like myself.
Yeah.
I believe who I am as a person, whether it's professional, at home, at play, at university, or whatever. People tend to look at me, and I look at myself as being a genuine person, a kind and caring person, not assertive, but a little bit more of a teddy bear, where I'm a little more relaxed. And I'm a kind of a people pleaser.
Yeah.
And that is who I am as a person, and I wouldn't want to change that, because I have a gentle nature about myself, and I don't want that to ever be altered.
Yeah.
Yes, I'd say so. I'd say when I'm around other people, I tend to be a little more energetic and talk a lot more, especially if I'm comfortable around them, like my friends mainly. Whereas if around like a bunch of other people I don't know, like strangers, then I become more quiet, more reserved, and I tend to not feel like the need to socialize.
Yeah, like I was saying. Yeah. Every time that I go back home, it's more like, I guess, like fun in a way, because like it's your family, your friends. And I feel like it's kind of like two different lives. You're not there, neither here. So, yeah, I think it definitely affects like where you go, like the people that you meet, their perspectives, their way of thinking.
I don't think there's different versions of myself. I think that in different settings, in a conference, I'm not gonna jump up and yell if I see something. It's important to be aware of your surroundings, who you're with, and that's what makes us human, is knowing when we can blurt out something and when we need to be quiet and listen to what's going on. It's just part of civilization and being liking people and loving life enough to not want to rock the boat.
I suppose when you're interacting with professors or persons at your place of work, for example, I'm a server right now, and I'm obviously going to be different to them than I would be to my friends or family or even random persons on the street.
Yeah.
Professors, I'm always going to act, generally speaking, more professionally.
Yeah, more diligently.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Delicately even.
Yeah.
Whereas, so I guess that is a different self represented.
Do you value authenticity in other people?
When other people like to be themselves, sometimes people take it the wrong way and they think, I gotta be exactly how I feel about every single thing. And some people are just like, come across
like extreme.
As like extreme, and yeah. They're just like, okay. And sometimes it's good to be yourself completely, but I mean, some people take it the wrong way and they feel like they have to be themselves in every single way, and they don't, like, they cross the boundary.
Definitely.
The respect level, and sometimes that's not really okay.
Yeah, I love it when I see people who are what you see is what you get. I have met people, especially being in the customer service industry and being in the airline industry, which I am in, where you can kind of see who maybe not be so real. And but again, I have to be true to myself and just be real to myself and not worry about how other people are.
Yeah, I'd value it, but do I know if it's real? Probably not. You know, I really expect them to be truthful, but you know, the world is so not there anymore. Everybody's so selfish, and you know, they all want, it's all me, and I want, you know, a watch, I want this, I want a car, I want a house, and it's all these material things, and you create this whole vision of like, this is what I gotta look like, and you know, don't create that for yourself. Just be who you are, and everything else will just happen.
When you feel that someone is honest with you, you are more you're more likely to trust and to express yourself like how you are. Like, you don't have to pretend to be someone you're not.
Right.
That's really important.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
You can tell generally when people are authentic. There are obviously going to be a few persons who are probably playing and that you seem to think they're authentic, but for the most time, you can tell when people are being authentic or not.
Yes.
And I value it.
Yeah.
I mean, why would I want to communicate with somebody being fake? And the point of communication is understanding. And if you can't understand what someone's actually communicating to you because they're fake, then why bother?
Yeah.
Really, it's just a waste of my time.
I value authenticity in other people, yes, but I understand that some people have different issues in their lives that keep them from being able to show that. It's good to be authentic. It's good to be, it's safe here. It's safe for you to be who you are. That's important. That's for great. People to feel safe to express who they are.
What are the challenges that you face when trying to be your true self in life?
Some of the challenges I do have is when I meet somebody who is a hard nose and who, when we meet head on, because I tend to be a teddy bear, I don't know if you've heard of that expression, where you're soft and gentle and a little more quiet natured,
yeah.
I kind of shut down.
Yeah.
And that person who may be a bit of a shark will take over who I am as a person and maybe almost break my free spirit. And as I get older, I'm more aware of that, and I can protect myself a little bit more, mm-hmm. and be real to myself by removing myself from the situation, and just remembering that I'm only responsible for my own actions, my own feelings.
Mm-hmm. The language barrier is a big thing, because like, you try to say one thing, and the other person might not get it as you want it to, or you want to mean one thing and the other person like doesn't really understand what you're trying to say, or if you come across the way that they expect, or they misinterpret what you are trying to say.
I find when you are fake to other people and don't act how you really feel or say how you really feel about certain things, then it goes to like bad and unhealthy relationships. And sometimes the reason why you don't act true to yourself is because when you talk to other people, you're afraid that they won't want to be your friend anymore, or they'll like, you'll lose them. Mm-hmm. And you get kind of scared about that, so you act fake for your own safety and to save the relationship.
Yeah.
But that's not always a good idea. That's not always healthy either. Mm. And sometimes if you lose people and they walk away from you, it can actually be like the best thing in life, and you won't realize it. Like, it can be a big weight lifted off to you, and you've been holding something back the whole time, and then when they're gone, it's like you can finally let it out, and then everything will be okay, and then it gets better.
My biggest resistance of being myself is, well, it's always about avoiding looking bad, you know. It's always about looking good and avoiding looking bad. Always that. It doesn't matter, you know, who you are, what it is, and I always want to look good. Mm-hmm. So if there's something that I'm gonna say that's gonna, you know, make me look bad in a way, I'm gonna withhold it.
There's many places on the planet where I couldn't, for example, hold hands with my boyfriend walking down the street. I couldn't be true to myself in that sense. I feel like that's obviously a huge honor, and I'm grateful to be able to express my love for my partner that way, mm-hmm. in public. I think hiding who you are is obviously going to be a negative, constrictive feeling.
Yeah.
I know it was for me for a long time, until I obviously came out. And for persons who can't do that, they don't even have that thought can't cross their mind. A person in my position in Saudi Arabia, for example, couldn't ever dream of doing that in Saudi Arabia.
Yeah.
For fear of jail time, possible execution, etc. Yeah. And that to me is a terrifying thought. When I was talking before about holding hands in the street with my boyfriend, for example, it could sometimes be persons uttering slurs, faggot, mm-hmm. etc., things like that, which obviously is off-putting and frustrating. It's also very surprising being in this location, I mean like the Lower Mainland, Vancouver, when you hear that, given that this area is supposed to be one of the most progressive places on the planet, certainly in Canada. Mm-hmm. So that's always upsetting and frustrating and just kind of makes me think they're dinosaurs, the persons who are talking like that, and clearly don't have any respect for other people.
Sometimes people don't understand that I am so in love with my faith, in love with God, mm-hmm. and happy about life.
Yeah.
They don't understand that that I can love them. Ohana means family, and in family, no one gets left behind.
It's a great motto. I'm starting to kind of see that there's different things about people, like whether it's like language or religion or any other aspect mm-hmm. of what a human makes a human in their mind. Like, there's always something that means the most that kind of affects their thoughts and how they do things.
Their perspective.
Life. Exactly, yeah. Mm-hmm. And I think that's so interesting how everyone has their own.
You're you. To be like you, it's not as ambiguous as that. No matter what you do, no matter how you change, it doesn't mean a thing. You're just you, no matter what. And I think that quote's really simple, but has a really powerful and deep meaning.
Yeah.
And I think we all look to be sometimes like everybody else, and we don't realize that we gotta be just like ourselves, and that's okay. And it doesn't matter.
Absolutely. Yeah, I agree with you.
There's gotta be a balance in everything in life.
I think so.
Whether it's alcohol or sex or conversation or being with groups of people or being by yourself.
Yeah.
Watching television.
Yeah.
Working.
Anything.
Enjoying life.
If you're gonna have to change yourself for people to accept you, then how is that actually, how is that positive, like, in the end? So I totally agree with you that
it's definitely not positive.
Yeah.
Because how long are you gonna be fake for? It's like the whole lying thing, like, you know, oh yeah, you know, I'm gonna, it's lying.
Like, this is what's right, and everyone who believes it is being honest, and everyone who isn't is lying to themselves.
But as long as, obviously, those points of view don't harm other persons.
Yeah, absolutely.
By that, I mean, like, Donald Trump's horrific comments of late talking about banning Muslims from in the United States, like, that is unbelievable. Or people who say, oh, like, gay marriage shouldn't exist, or women shouldn't have a right to their own bodies. Like, that's, why do you have control over them? That's when I take major offense. And
I don't have to prove myself to anybody. I am just who I am. And, mm-hmm. you know, life can be hard as it is. So I just try to just go with the flow and just be me.
That's
I think
good.
When you're trying to be somebody else or you're trying to change who you are, it doesn't give you that satisfaction in life that I think we all need, because life's short.